brazing process. The metal parts to be brazed should be cleaned. Cleaning may be done by brushing, filing or grinding. The parts are so joined that a gap should exist between them so that the filler metal may flow inside the joint. A small amount of flux is mixed with water to form a paste and it is applied to the surface to be brazed before they are heated. Then the surface to be brazed are heated to a temperature below their melting point. The flux applied on the work surface melts and flows in the gap between the surface. When the splitter is applied to the joint, it is melted. The molten splitter flows in the gap between the workpiece and solidifies, forming a hot braced joint. Next, coming to types of brazing. Depending on the source of heating, the brazing process may be classified as torch brazing, dip brazing, salt brazing, furnace brazing, induction brazing, resistance brazing. Coming to torch brazing. In torch brazing, the source of heat for brazing is from a gas flame torch. It may be oxyhydrogen or other gas flames. Dip brazing. In dip brazing, the pre-assembled metal joints are dipped in a bath of molten brazing metal. The molten brazing metal bath provides both the required heat and the brazing metal for the joint. It is usually adapted for small parts. Next, salt brazing. In salt brazing, the assembled parts are dipped in a bath of molten salt kept at a temperature slightly above the melting point of the brazing metal. The brazing metal is pre-placed in the joint and the molten salt bath provides the heat to melt it. Next, furnace brazing. In furnace brazing, the assembled metal joins the pre-placed brazing metal are kept in controlled atmosphere or vacuum furnace. Because of the easy control of brazing temperature and as skilled labor is not required, furnace brazing is used for mass production. Next, induction brazing. In induction brazing, high frequency induction current is used for heating the joints. Induction brazing requires a simple heating coil which should fit around the joint to provide the heating at the required area. The brazing metal is pre-placed in the metal joint. Next, resistant brazing. In resistant brazing, the metals to be joined are held under pressure between two electrodes. The heating is due to the electric resistance between the electrodes when electric current is passed through them.